interesting ideas that bring so many people from the village together. Happen like this. So just an example of some of the things that they do. They're in charge of the project nights that you have every spring. They also started the fall project nights now. They have the garden contest. I actually met one of the garden contest winners recently. Volunteers selecting areas in town to work on through the year to clean up. And then
efforts to improve the appearance of Brookfield and the general state of mind of its residents during this difficult economic time. We can do more with limited financial resources, as exemplified by the Brookfield Beautification Committee, local artists, RV High School students and teachers, the Brookfield Chamber of Commerce, and local business and residents in the creation of this park. I commend all of you for your outstanding efforts. This progress and the First National Bank of Brookfield is proud to be a part of this progress and proud to continue working towards a better Brookfield. And I'm proud to introduce Cheryl McBride Leslie, who is the chairperson of the Brookfield Beautification Commission.
Have been possible without the extraordinary cooperation and coordination of several individuals and organizations who came together to create this beautiful gift of beauty. A quote attributed to Chief Seattle of the Squamish Indians was the theme that exemplifies our park. This we know. The earth does not belong to man. Man belongs to the earth. We are all connected by the blood that unites us all. Man did not weave the web of life. He is merely a strand in it. What he does to the web, he does to himself. In April of this year, the Brookfield Beautification Commission took this concept to the Riverside Brookfield High School Fine Arts Department with the idea of creating a mural with the four panels and the four elements of nature and also conservation. Four elements of nature are, of course, earth, wind, water, and sun or fire. The task assigned to the students was to create this four-panel mural with a ribbon of wind running through, connecting the elements. The concept being, we are all connected, and we need to protect the earth. Progress Park exemplifies a community that is connected, caring, and concerned with conservation. This park was created totally by volunteers with a devotion to enhancing the beauty of our village. Many have contributed to the success of this project, Our deepest gratitude, of course, goes to First National Bank of Brookfield, who allowed us to use this land. A special thanks goes to Phil Robert, who was very generous with his time and kept the process moving for us. All of the funds of this project were generously donated by Brookfield Friends of the Library, the Brookfield Chamber of Commerce, CEP Youth Leadership, and Robert and Peggy Evans. Thank you for believing in this project. Many local businesses donated their time and or materials, and we want to thank them as well. Freeman Fence for constructing the mural structure, Atrium Landscape Management for installing the landscape materials, Catchmark Landscape and Design for creating the path, our biggest neighbor, Brookfield Zoo, who created the Eagle Bench, Vulcan Materials for donating the boulders, and Sign Up Sign Company for creating the signage. In addition, we would like to thank local artist Carol Markoff for creating the artwork for the signage, graphic designer Linda Dunbar for creating the BBC logo, landscape architect Michael Snow for creating the landscape plan, artist Dante DiBartolo for installing the mural, which was no easy task, believe me. Tammy McBride and Brian Elward for donating their time and talent on the final touches of the mural and the artwork. And the following for donating plants for the park: Brook Park School, Liz Hahn, Jenny DeRose, Dorothy Ball, Pam Pondell, Sylvia Koenig, and Char Kruger. Thank you all very much. Our utmost appreciation goes to the talented RB High School students who created this beautiful mural and the original poetry that you'll find in the park. Nick Gell, the department chair of fine arts, enthusiastically guided his students in creating this truly beautiful, inspiring piece of art. The original poetry was created using the Brookfield Zoo's Say It in Seven program, which is creating seven-word poems that focus on conservation. The students created the verse based on the four elements, and there are four pavers in front of the Eagle Bench, so if you haven't seen those, please check those out. This mural would not have been possible without the talent and vision of local artist Sonata Casimir-Etienne. Sonata volunteered countless hours in guiding the BBC through the process, and also in working with the students in design development and execution. It was fascinating watching Sonata take the concepts that were presented by the students and creating the sketch in a matter of minutes. Please join me in welcoming Sonata Casimir-Etienne.
It was a pleasure to work with the committee, and I just want to mention how I get involved. One day I just read a short article in the paper, in the local paper, that there is this new entity, beautification committee, that was starting kind of develop a plan for Brookfield, and being a professional artist and had been working in public art for last five, 6 years, I thought, well, if I'm here and this thing is happening, I would like to be part of it. So I just went to one of the meetings and introduced myself, and I offered to help if there some help would be needed. And soon after that, I heard back from him and Carol that this is first project that they are planning to put together, and it was a pleasure to work with those two women, and I'm admiring their organizational skills, and how many times we would run into some problem, and then Pam would say, okay, I'll take care of that, I'll call, I'll make calls, I'll check with these people, with that people. And there were a couple moments when I was thinking, gosh, it's not gonna happen. I mean, we were so close to not to happen, at least at that time schedule that we wanted to, but it happened, and it's beautiful, and I'm really impressed, and I'm really happy to be part of it, and I feel honored to be able to contribute my time to the village, to the community where I live.
I'd like to introduce
Andre Copeland from the zoo.
Thank you. I'm not going to take up too much of your time, but my name is Andre Copeland, and I'm the Interpretive Programs Manager for the Chicago Zoological Society. The Society manages the destination Brookfield Zoo, which is part of this community. And the mission of the Society is to inspire conservation leadership by connecting people with wildlife and nature. And two of the most important words in the Society's mission are connection and people. And this is why we are extremely excited about what you're being part of here today. Back in 2010, I met one of the members of the Beautification Commission, Jane Huber, when she came to a program I was doing at the Brookfield Library, Bison Paving the Way. Talk about the connections between bison, our culture, our current society, and our first Americans. Jane started to talk to me about the good work that the Beautification Commission was going to be doing in Brookfield and asked, would the zoo want to be a part of that? I said, it's not a question as to whether or not the zoo wants to be a part of that. It's a question of why wouldn't the society need to be a part of that? Many of us feel that the zoo is our second home, some our first home. We feel that this is part of our community, part of our lives. So when I went for two people who were overworked, overwhelmed at the zoo, and asking my buddy Krista, can you design a bench that would actually complement what they're doing here with four elements? She said, of course. Why not tie it into Great Bear Wilderness? We'll use the eagle. I said, great. The eagle rides on the wind, soars close to the sun, and sometimes is considered the firebird. Gets its sustenance from the water and perches and oversees the land. I said, great, I love your inspiration, and pulling together, working with people, we were able to accomplish this first step, because we will continue to work with the Beautification Commission to beautify our community. So we just want to say thank you very much for allowing us to be a part of this, and to let you know that you will continue to always have our support. Thank you. I would like to introduce, I'm sorry, Pam. She is the principal of Riverside Brookfield High School. They do a lot of great work with us, and let's give them a big round of applause, because without them,
public art is a powerful thing. It transforms ordinary spaces into statements about who we are as a community. More than a representation of how much we value our environment, public art becomes an expression of our identity, a source of pride, and an investment in our future. With its artwork and poetry, this public park will grow into a treasured place of reflection that will connect with people in a very personal way, stirring up their thoughts and emotions. The fact that the Brookfield's Beautification Committee created Progress Park elevates this village above the ordinary community. But what makes this project and this village truly special is the fact that they didn't do it alone. They recognized the opportunity to collaborate on the project with Riverside Brookfield High School and our Fine Arts and English departments. This partnership afforded our students a valuable learning experience and the opportunity to work with professional artists and community leaders. This project gave them the chance to learn new skills, to share talents they already had, and to see the end product displayed for all to enjoy. But more than this, the collaboration sent out a message to our students that the adults in this community regard them as valuable resources. Teenagers have so much to offer their communities. They possess imagination, skill, talent, energy, and focus. Young adults are willing to contribute in productive ways, but they need to be invited in. It is for this reason that I am deeply appreciative of Pam Powers and the Brookfield Beautification Commission. As the principal of RB, I thank them for recognizing that our students are individuals who can contribute in full measure, and for affording them the chance to move from the abstract concept of citizenship to the concrete experience of it. The beauty of this space and the power of its message are enhanced by the spirit of intergenerational cooperation that contributed to its creation. when you come to spend time in this park, or when you simply pass by it. I hope you remember that fact and are touched by it. I know I will. Thank you very much. Now, so that you get to meet those talented students and teachers, I'm going to introduce you to Mr. Nick Gale. Okay. He is the chairman, or the department chair, of our fine arts department. It is an award-winning fine arts department that last year was recognized by the Illinois Arts Alliance for Art Education as being the high school in the state of distinction for our wonderful fine arts program. And so, okay.
Thank you very much. I'm not as well spoken as Pam, so I apologize. But we have been thanked for being a part of this process, but we actually need to be doing some of the thanking. I want to thank the Beautification Committee for inviting us to be part of this. You know, throughout the school year, the students were very much focused on their own work, and this really provided them an opportunity to give something back, to collaborate with each other. It was an interesting process to watch. We had a great group of students. They got to work with a professional artist and collaborate with her on some of her ideas. But we also need to thank her for really letting the students and empowering the students to really shine and show their true abilities and their skills. You know, not once did she ever come in and kind of steer them in a direction or correct them in any way. She really guided them and taught them some lessons that they hadn't learned before. So, you know, it was really a great opportunity for our students and a great opportunity for our school as well. And then taking it to the next level and incorporating our creative writing students, you know, this whole process and this whole environment here has completely changed. And it's going to be exciting for years to come for them to come back to their community and see some of their efforts. So we want to thank them for, again, allowing us to be a part of this. At this time, I want to introduce some of the students who are a part of this, and I believe they're going to read some of the poetry, some of the Say It in Seven poetry that was written. So I'd like to introduce Salem Bear and Annalise Gibson and Kristen Santoro and Candace Shelbrick.
Nature's beauty is found in pure simplicity, the magnanimous. Air, unleash fury with incomprehensible power beyond man. Tommy Halichek and David Thompson. Water, continuously flowing, sheltering, creating, and replenishing life, Amanda Gregus.
Sun and fire, illuminating the horizon, glowing yellow to red, Taylor Dome.
Earth, wide open spaces where earth meets sky, Molly Ely and Caitlin Markowski. Air, free-flowing and everlasting for all, Molly Ely and Caitlin Markowski.
Water, this ebb and flow reflects all things, Colette Lucas.
Sun and fire, shining bright through clouds, powering all life that he needs.
Earth, mountains rise, prairies flow, water down below, just as it.
Air, the wind blows and I feel anew, Lauren Mayaki.
Water, fundamental element, the origin of life, Tori Verse.
Sun and fire, rays of warmth, bears all living things, Louise Gangwire.
Before we commence with the ribbon cutting ceremony, I'd just like to take this opportunity to thank all of the Brookfield Beautification Commissioners for all those extra meetings and long hours that it took to accomplish our first community art project. In particular, I would like to thank the chair of our community art program, Pam Powers. You've heard her name several times tonight. Without Pam's leadership and dedication to keep this project moving at the quick pace that was necessary, it would not have happened this year. Pam is a dynamo. We had lots of hurdles, but Pam she cleared them every single time. So thank you, Pam. Before we start with the ribbon cutting ceremony, I just want to mention we have refreshments. We also have some information on the Brookfield Beautification Commission. So please join us afterwards. We are trying to start a Friends of the Beautification Commission. If any of you are interested, we'll have more information on our website soon. So thank you all for coming, and all of those involved in the ribbon cutting ceremony, if you could come up here. Here it is.
looking for our photo. Maybe we can make it a little more of an arc so that we can get everyone in. Kind of come this way.
Yeah, circle of life, right?
Okay, Pam, you need to get in there, and I need to get all the boots up. BBC members. BBC. Commissioners.
Nicole. Where are we going?
Nicole, put in. Welcome everyone. Here is Progress Park.
What?
Well, we need to wait. One, two, three. This really doesn't cut. All right, so go ahead. Okay, here we go.
One.
Seen him on TV. So when did the Jaws come? That's a good thing. Jaws birthed me. That was a cute little ceremony. I like public awareness.